It's easy to tell who the highest paid basketball players in the NBA are because their salaries are public knowledge. However, in the EuroLeague, it is much tougher to know who are the top earners. Here at BasketNews.com, we have researched this topic and compiled a list of the top 10 highest paid EuroLeague players. Just outside the list are Kostas Sloukas, Nick Kalates, and Nando De Colo, who make between 1.8 to 1.9 million euros per season. Let's dive into the top 10. Number 10, Niccolò Melli. Milan sacrificed a lot to get Niccolò Melli back to Europe by letting Zach Lidé go. However, the team made big moves and gave Melli a solid 3-year contract. Basket News sources say Melli will earn more than 2 million euros per season, making him the highest paid player in Milan. The team hopes that he was one of the missing pieces to their championship puzzle. Number 9, Walter Tavares. Tavares might not be the highest paid player in the EuroLeague, but he arguably holds the highest NBA buyout in Europe. According to Basket News sources, Tavares' buyout is even more significant than the one Facundo Campazzo had at 6 million euros. In 2019, Tavares agreed to a 5-year contract with Real Madrid and is set to make around 2.1 million euros this season. The 29-year-old hidden gem from Cape Verde made the All-EuroLeague first team last season, and there's no reason why he should stop being the most dominant EuroLeague center. 7-8, Alexei Shved. Shved was set for at least 3 well-paid years in Himki, until the Russian club fell apart and vanished from the elite of European basketball. But the best Russian player quickly found a solution out of a complicated situation. He switched from Moscow region to the capital, and from the worst EuroLeague team to a title contender. Per Basket News sources, his compensation from a big Himki sponsor and his new contract with Teska will combine to around 2.2 million euros per year. His old contract with Himki would have listed Shved in the top 4, but it's still not too bad to remain in the top 8 before turning 33 in December. Shved is the oldest player on this top 10 list. 7-8, Mike James. Sharing the 7th and 8th spot with Alexei Shved is arguably the best scorer in the EuroLeague. Mike James. Our sources say that he will earn close to 1 million euros in AS Monaco, making him the highest paid player in the French Basketball League history. But it wouldn't be fair to rank him based only on his income from his newest EuroLeague team. James parted ways with Teska Moscow, receiving a solid compensation. Adding it to James's salary, the guard will make around 2.2 million euros this year. This amount also makes him the second highest paid US player in the EuroLeague. Number 6, Nikola Milutinov. Despite everyone talking about Milutinov potentially moving to the San Antonio Spurs, he signed a 3-year contract with Teska Moscow in 2020. Per Basket News sources, this year, Milutinov will earn from 2.3 to 2.5 million euros, which makes him the highest paid center in the EuroLeague. Also, at age 26, Milutinov is the youngest player on this top 10. He missed most of the last season due to a shoulder injury and is out this year once again. However, the Serbian center should be back on the floor sooner rather than later. Number 5, Tornike Shengelia. Signing with Teska was one of the most complex decisions Tornike Shengelia ever had to make. Even the president of Georgia, Salome Zurabishvili, reacted to Shengelia's move to Russia, calling it unacceptable. In 2020, Teska paid a buyout of around 1 million euros for his transfer from Vitoria to Moscow and signed Shengelia to a 3-year contract. According to Basket News sources, Shengelia earns around 2.5 million euros per season. Number 4, Jan Veselý. Although he had to take a pay cut last year when Fenerbahce started the rebuild with a reduced budget, Veselý remains the highest paid player on the team. According to Basket News sources, his salary ranges from 2.6 to 2.8 million euros. Even though Veselý is on an expiring contract and is set to hit free agency in the summer of 2022, it's hard to imagine Fenerbahce without the flying Czech, who's been with the team since 2014. Number 3, Vasilij Micić. Micić became the most expensive free agent in the summer of 2021. Receiving the most significant salary increase compared to the last contract. Now it's around 2 times higher than the previous one. Anadolu Efes had to spend around 3.1 million euros for the upcoming season to keep their best player, and that's without bonuses, which might increase the MVP's income by more than half a million euros. It's also only the first year of Vasilije's 3-year guaranteed deal. Efes had to open their wallet because Teska tried persuading Micić to come to Moscow, offering him a contract in June. Efes matched it, and without having a clear path in Oklahoma City Thunder, Micić decided to remain in Europe. Number 2, Shane Larkin. The EuroLeague champions accommodate two of the three best paid players in the league. One of them is the highest paid US player in the EuroLeague. Basket News sources indicate that he shares a very similar salary with Vasilije Micić. But Micić could surpass Larkin if he reaches his bonuses. But as of right now, Larkin has a slight advantage over his teammate, with a salary of 3.2 million euros. Larkin had an NBA out clause in his contract, but a solid deal with Efes convinced him not to chase NBA opportunities. Number 1, Nikola Mirotić. Nikola Mirotić kept the most significant contract in Europe, around 5 million euros net per season, sources tell Basket News. Compared to the NBA, the highest paid EuroLeague player gets something similar to the average NBA player's salary, which was $12.2 million before taxes last season. 2 years ago, Mirotić had an offer from Utah, but despite having a 3-year guaranteed deal prepared on the table in the Jazz front office, Mirotić canceled the flight at the last minute and left the NBA. Let us know your thoughts on these EuroLeague stars and their salaries in the comments. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Basket News for more content. Thank you, and we'll see you in the next video.